You need a complete list of every IT asset, software, and hardware in your company. How can we build this quickly? Let's build it together, right now, using InvGate Insight. Hi, I'm Matt Barron, Product Specialist at InvGate. Whether you're trying to get away from Excel inventories, or you're being faced with audits, or just answering your boss's questions about how many computers or licenses you have, we can help you get a complete inventory in just a day or two. And you can do this for free with a free trial of InvGate Insight, and then later turn this into your production instance. Pick up a free trial at the link in the description below. Once you've got your trial, we're going to populate assets using a couple different methods. The first, simplest and fastest way to get your computers, servers, and mobile devices reporting is to install an agent. This can be installed many different ways, directly on the machines you have access to or remotely. For Windows machines, you can use a GPO, WMI, or PS exec if you've got remote access. For Macs and Linux, you can do it directly or with SSH. And for Android phones, the app will be installed using the Google Play Store. We can't use agents on iPads or iPhones yet, but we do have a Jamf connection you can use if you manage your devices through Jamf, or you can integrate with another mobile device management system or MDM tool. To get started, we're going to get the agent loaded on my Mac as well as my PC. To get the agent installed, you're going to go to Settings, Network, and then make sure you're in the Agent Deployment section. In here, you select the operating system, the deployment method, where it's going to report to, and the type of installation, whether it's new or a reinstall. And then below, you'll see the instructions. For a Mac, the instructions are simple. Just run these three commands in terminal. I'll copy the first command to download the agent install package. Copy the command to extract the package. And finally, the last command to install it. I'll need to blind type my password to give administrator access. And that's it. The agent is installed. And now I'm going to do the same thing on my Windows 11 machine. For Windows machines, you go to the same screen, select Windows, of course. I'm going to use the manual deployment method, same server, and a new installation. Now the instructions below are a little bit different. I'm going to download an MSI, so I'll pop this URL into Edge. Then instead of running the MSI, we're going to copy the command to install this, and we need to run command line as an administrator. Now I need to navigate to where the MSI is. And we'll run the command. This will pop open the installer. And that's it. As you can see, it is very easy to get the agent installed. These machines will start reporting to Insight in just a couple minutes. For the other ways to distribute the agent via GPO or SSH, you can select those methods on this same screen, and it's going to give you instructions below along with some knowledge articles. These are provided to make this much easier. And as always, if you run into problems, you can always get in touch with our support team. The next way to get your computers and other network gear loaded into InvGate Insight is to use Discovery. Discovery will use a proxy server to crawl your network and discover internet-connected devices. And don't worry, you'll specify the parts of your network to discover. This won't just scan all your IPs by default. Once you're ready to use this in production, you can do a gradual rollout if you'd like, segmenting by subnet on your network, by location, or however you need to. To get started, you'll need a computer or server running Windows or Linux on the network you want to discover. I'll be running this on my home network with a Windows machine. To get started, we'll go to Settings, Network, and Proxies. Here, we're going to download the manual, which is going to give us the link to download the proxy installer. Once again, I'll pop this URL into Edge, and it's going to download the proxy installer. For the proxy installation, I go to the download, extract the files, and simply run the installation file. I need to grant permission. And now we'll walk through the wizard. Most of the defaults here are going to be just fine for this setup. You may need to change the port number if the agents are trying to reach this proxy server. Just make sure that you work with your network administrators to configure this properly. Now, I got one security pop-up to allow access to my networks. I'm going to click Allow, and now the wizard is complete. Once the installation is complete, we're going to get a proxy setup screen to finish this setup. We'll click through this wizard. I'm going to grab the URL from my Insight instance. I'm just going to name this Matt Proxy. And now we'll populate the IP address for the URL of this proxy server. It's going to check that URL, and we go on to the next step to set up the database. Once the database is set up, we just scroll through these migrations to apply, click on Run Migrations, and wait for it to finish. Once completed, click Continue. Now we're done with the install. The next step will be to configure the discovery. First, we'll click Refresh to validate that our proxy server is successfully connected. And then we'll go to Discovery Sources. We'll click Add. I'm going to call this my daily discovery. And we'll choose InvGate Discovery here. Once selected, this will allow me to choose my configured proxy and fill in the IP range that I want to discover. Below the IP range, there are other details, like the specific protocols we're going to use while we're crawling your network, along with the details for those protocols. The defaults will work in most cases, so work with your network administrators again to make sure that this works. And near the bottom of the screen, you'll see the schedule for this discovery. I'm going to set this to run every day at 2200 or 10 p.m. Now, I'll scroll to the top and click Save. Now, if I want to kick this off manually, I can click on this lightning bolt here to sync, and you can see that discovery kicks off and is now running. This can take a little bit of time, especially if you've got a large network with a lot of equipment. Now, my network isn't huge, so we'll be able to see the results in just a moment. After a few minutes, it looks like discovery has completed. So now, to see the devices that I've recently discovered, I can go to the Assets panel. And up here at the top, there are three tabs, and you can see there are 34 new discovered devices from my network. I can see most of the things I expected to find. We don't automatically assume that you want to track these items, though. So to convert them to managed assets, I'll need to actually select the device that I'd like to add, and then choose Convert to Asset. This will ask me to validate some information. The manufacturer and model number are required. This is my primary router, so I'm selecting the type here, and I'm just going to fill in the model number and hit Apply. I can also populate as much information here as I want, or add this later. This will ask me to validate the data. And now, let me take a few moments to convert some more of these items. Okay, I've converted about 10 of those items. Now I can go back to the Explorer tab and see all the devices that are in my network that I want to manage. So now we have machines that are reporting in with the agent, We have the discovery running on our network. Next, we'll add some cloud accounts to manage our servers from Azure, as well as our mobile devices in Jamf. You can also add AWS and Google Cloud very easily. To set up these cloud sources, go to Settings, Network, and Discovery Sources. To add your cloud provider, simply choose Add, provide a name, and select the cloud provider type. This is going to prompt you for some additional information, which you'll need to populate from your accounts. In this case, I'm going to put in our Azure IDs, as well as the access key and the tenant ID. Once we validate and continue, you'll see some additional options here, like choosing which subscriptions you actually want to sync and what to do with instances once they're deleted in Azure. Do we want them deleted in Insight or do we want to keep them? That sort of thing. You can see a familiar schedule option down below. We're just going to change this to every day for my case, and you can run a test if you'd like. I'll hit save, and now we'll add Jamf as well. Once I select the product type, it's going to give me the URL and login credentials. And again, I can validate and continue. Once again, I get additional options like syncing specific asset types and the scheduler down below. I'll run a quick test, hit save. And now these devices will start to synchronize within 10 or 15 minutes. I am going to manually run the synchronization right now. And in a few minutes, you'll start seeing your cloud devices. So now we've got our agents installed on workstations, discoveries pulling in our network devices, Azure and Jamf are reporting our cloud devices. Let's take a look at some of these devices and what we're able to do with our inventory. Now, I'm on my home network, so my inventory is going to look a lot different from yours, but you can quickly see how easy it is for me to pick through my individual assets and get exactly what I need. For instance, I can just query for tablets, and it's going to show me just the tablets that are in those systems. You can see my Jamf devices, as well as the iPads that were discovered on my network. Now, let's do computers. Here are the computers, as well as the devices that are being discovered on my network. And if I go into one of these computers, you can see a ton of information here. Things like the hardware details, what operating system it's running, who logged into it last. Under the hardware tab, I can see even more specific details around the RAM or the logical drives, which printers are installed, including the software that's been installed on this computer. Another great feature is the financial tab, which is going to allow us to track the depreciation and original costs on our assets. And I really like this activity tab, which is going to show everything that changes on these devices going forward, from restarts and logins to printers and software installations. This is a very useful feature for diagnosing machines and tracking changes to your assets. And this is just the beginning. By adding users and locations in here, you can start to get a picture of how useful an inventory like this can be for IT operations. And if you incorporate this into your service desk workflows, you can maintain this inventory and keep it accurate. If you like what you've seen here, consider subscribing to our YouTube channel or following us on LinkedIn. We've got a ton of good content out there, just like this video and the ones that are going to follow it. We're always adding more because we want to help people in the IT industry. So I hope you found this video useful. And as always, please remember, good service is good business. Have a great day.